This is a chill out evening stream, and I'm not speaking, as you can see, and Johnny has just realized, so we can enjoy the Worms music.
is the continuing saga of courage, honor, and worms. Many generations have passed since we were last witness to such a raging war. Long forgotten by creatures who dwell on the world's surface, the ongoing struggle of the worms had caused much bloodshed as cults and clans battled on for dominance of the world. Over the years, Boggy B had seen many a bloody battle, yet still he fights on. For glory, for honor, and for his fallen friends, he must settle the score so that future generations may live without fear of airstrikes and grenades or face the hardship every day that the war has brought upon his world. If anything, life as a worm had become even more dangerous. Experiments had brought new and more powerful weapons to the battle. Stories of exploding bananas were used to scare the young ones from mischief. Sometimes even hardened war veterans could not hide their simmering fear. We join Clagnut, son of Spadge, as he sets out on a scouting mission behind enemy lines. The memory of his father clear in his mind, Clagnut carefully peeked over a leaf. It was then to his horror he saw his uncle Boggy B trapped in a cave, and the enemy's evil smile as he reached for the soft fruit of doom. Was the moment he had trained for since he was only half an inch long. Using the rope he had packed, Clagnut lowered himself down the hill. Primed for action, silent and deadly as only the slimiest of worms can be, he crouched down and quietly squirmed up behind his foe, prepared to make it count. At such close range, a grenade or a banana would surely make things worse. So he drew his baseball bat and struck his foe across the neck with a mighty swing. The enemy flew high and into the abyss, where Boggy then rained three cows upon his head. And once again, the cry was heard far across the land, "We've won the war!"
is the continuing saga of courage, honor, and worms. Many generations have passed since we were last witness to such a raging war. Long forgotten by creatures who dwell on the world's surface, the ongoing struggle of the worms had caused much bloodshed as cults and clans battled on for dominance of the world. Over the years, Boggy B had seen many a bloody battle, yet still he fights on. For glory, for honor, and for his fallen friends, he must settle the score so that future generations may live without fear of air.
So, this was the fastest one, probably, that I've done so far. Thank you for tuning in to Worms Radio. This song is basically repeating, so you just heard it right now. I'm going to stop it now. I'm going to finish this. And possibly I'm going to do something even more stupid right now, which will be trying to get through the intro of Far Cry 5. Because I'm going to do a stream of Far Cry 5 with my brother, a co-stream, in 2 days. And I tried the hardest difficulty on Far Cry 5 and I couldn't get through. So, if you want to see some strange, crazy, stupid things live, tune in a few minutes to check out Far Cry 5 hardest difficulty run of a guy who doesn't really know how to play Far Cry 5. Thank you again for watching this and listening to the Worms Radio. Have a great day, night, evening, morning, or whichever day you chose to watch this video. Bye bye, adios.
And the enemy's evil smile as he reached for the soft fruit of doom. This was the moment he had trained for since he was only half an inch long. Using the rope he had packed, Clagnut lowered himself down the hill. Primed for action, silent and deadly as only the slimiest of worms can be, he crouched down and quietly squirmed up behind his foe, prepared to make it count. At such close range, a grenade or a banana would surely make things worse. So he drew his baseball bat and struck his foe across the neck with a mighty swing. The enemy flew high and into the abyss, where Boggy then rained 3 cows upon his head. And once again, the cry was heard far across the land, "We've won the war!"